Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Chesnara CEO, Steve Murray. Steve, very good to see you again.
Great to see you as well. I hope you're surviving all this windy weather.
Indeed, yeah, windy and wet. Steve, we haven't chatted for a while, so it's a good time to catch up ahead of your next results release. Take us through some of the 2023 milestones for the company, because it really was a big year for you.
Yeah, it was. It was a busy time on a number of fronts. Operationally, one of the key things that we did last year was announced a strategic partnership with SS&C in the UK. So they'll be our key partner for outsourced services going forward. And that'll certainly assist the UK M&A strategy as well. So there was a huge amount of work that went into that, and we're well underway with the work that we need to do to implement that partnership. M&A again was on the agenda for us. So we announced two transactions, as you'll remember, during the year as well. One in the Netherlands, which was an insurance portfolio from Conservatrix, and one in the UK, where we purchased a protection portfolio from Candle Life. And then on the people side, it was a busy period for us. So at the back end of the year, we announced the transition from Dave Rimmington, our current group finance director, and said that he would be leaving at the AGM this year in May, with Tom Howard coming in. And then across our businesses, we also transitioned leadership there as well, and brought in three new chief executives during the year. And from my perspective, it was great to be able to do that from a position of stability and strength. And we're already seeing the positive difference that they're making as well. And obviously, alongside that, we spoke to you at the half year about the results, which I think were well received by shareholders. So yeah, it was, when you look back, you suddenly realize how busy you've been across the year. So
let's go back to the partnership with SS&C, Steve. You said it's part of your UK acquisition strategy. What is that strategy? Can you refresh us?
Yeah, so as a reminder, so the main insurance company that we have in the UK is Countrywide Assured. It's predominantly closed to new business. So while we accept increments into the existing policies that we have, and we write a little bit of new business, mainly that's a book that's in runoff. And what we're trying to do is run that very effectively, but ideally add to the scale of that through M&A. And that can be portfolio transactions, where we take a small book from a larger insurer, or we can look at full legal entities as well. And that's been a huge part of Chesnara's story. And one of the things that we're hopeful that the SS&C deal will give us is a kind of scalable platform, far newer technology, and also a partner that really wants to grow with us as well. So we do see that as a key enabler for that M&A strategy, and we're excited about what we might be able to do with that in the future.
So yeah, you mentioned the two acquisitions you made last year, the Canada Life UK portfolio, as well as the Conservatrix portfolio. How have those been bedded down, Steve?
Yeah, they've gone well. On Canada Life, there's a lot of work to do just to get to the Part 7 date. So as a reminder, in the UK, there's a kind of court process that you have to go through to migrate policies and take them from one insurance company to another. So it's relatively early days around that. But I think in terms of putting the reinsurance agreement in place that moved the economic value of that business to us, that all went well and straightforwardly in May time. And then the integration of Conservatrix is very much complete. We've now got a combined operating model within VARD that has those Conservatrix people that came to us, and the systems migration has been completed as well. So we're pleased with that progress, and that certainly means that we're very much open to new M&A opportunities when we think about 2024.
You mentioned the new finance director, Tom Howard, joining in May, and he was previously the CFO at Aviva. So a steady set of hands, I suppose, for that very important position.
Yeah, very much so. I mean, look, we were delighted to be able to find somebody of Tom's talent in the market. He's got a good insurance background, so he's an actuary by trade originally. But more recently, he's been the CFO of the investment company within Aviva as well. And that's obviously an important part of our strategy, making sure that we do a great job with the assets that we manage. So we're looking forward to Tom joining. Dave's done a super job for us over the last 10 years. And again, it's great to be able to make that transition when the company's in such a strong position. So I know Tom's keen to join us as soon as he can, and we're looking forward to welcome him into the organization later on in the year. So,
and looking at the strong position that you mentioned the company's in, Steve, 2023 was quite a tough year from a macroeconomic perspective. How did you weather that, and how do you feel as we head into 2024?
Yeah, we've been talking probably for the last 2 years, haven't we, about these kind of volatile macroeconomic conditions. So obviously kind of high inflation has been something for everybody to deal with. As an insurance company, whilst it's something that we've been very focused on, it probably has less of an impact on us than it might do other industries. And we've got some natural kind of hedges within the balance sheet, which have meant that throughout 2023, you know, the solvency position has remained strong, and we've continued to see good cash generation, which is something our shareholders have been accustomed to. So look, we would far rather have a nice, stable, steady market condition. But at the same time, it's been another period for us to demonstrate, you know, the real resilience that we've got within the balance sheet. And at the half year, you know, the solvency position of the group had increased in terms of that percentage ratio. Again, I think providing some certainty to investors that the group remained strong, and gave us the headroom as well to think about M&A as well. So look, for 2024, I think we'd like a bit more of a stable condition, as everybody would, but we weathered 2023 very, very well.
I'm sure we'll get more of your 2024 outlook when we chat about your results next month, but thank you very much for the update today.
Great talking to you, thanks.
Steve Murray is the CEO of Chesnara PLC.